By the way, this is my first unscripted video. Can you tell? I hate it already.
Hello, and welcome to the Enchanted Essays Critictube Question Tag. It's my 100 subscriber special. So, without further ado, let's start. Who is this for, and why did I create?
Well, I was watching creators on AuthorTube and BookTube, and I saw there was this thing called a newbie question tag, where new creators could answer the same questions and then find each other. It could be like a jumping off point for new viewers to get to know them. And to my surprise, I couldn't find any other communities in YouTube that who were doing the same thing, so I thought it'd be a great opportunity to do that. The creators that I have talked to through social media who create similar videos have been really wonderful, really supportive, and I thought this would be a good way to give back to them. So how it works is a series of questions that you can also answer on your own channel. This is for anyone with a channel about films or TV shows, etc. I'm kept it quite broad because obviously unlike something like talking about your experiences as an author or reviewing books, this is quite a broad topic. So, why did you create your channel? Was there anything in particular that inspired you? I'd been thinking of doing something on YouTube for a while, got very into video essays, and I ended up writing them, and I'd been dabbling in writing them for a while. And I decided when I had 5 complete essays and then I'd record them, then I would start my channel. I reached this goal in December, thought that the first Friday of January would be a great place to start, the first Friday of 2022.
So what media do you discuss? Do you discuss nostalgic things like Headphones UK or Epilot? Area Zero, do you look at anime like Part Eyes or The Recovering Elitist?
Obviously it doesn't need to be anything specific. With video essays, it really has to be on, you know, what inspires you, what kind of sets off that thing of, ooh, I see how this can be improved, or I can see how it works, I can see why it's as good as it is. What style of videos do you create? Do you create video essays? Do you create reviews? Obviously, I do both. When I started writing for my channel, I originally planned on just doing video essays, but I realised that obviously they take a long time to create, and then I could still keep a more regular upload schedule if I also did reviews. So I tend to do films that are older, that not a lot of people have heard of, that not so many people have reviewed on YouTube. Are you part of any fandoms? Obviously this isn't an essential thing, but if there's anything that you're more likely to post regularly because you're part of a specific fandom, that's always good to know, especially early on, that you know, more of a similar content is going to come out. For example, I'm part of the James Bond fandom. I've created 11 videos so far, and 2 of them have been about Bond films. I'm planning on doing more Bond videos, especially for September. It's just before the 60th anniversary. I'm also a big classic rock fan, so I have already done a film starring Ringo. I'm going to be reviewing a few more films starring Ringo and other classic rock singers / actors. And I'm also going to be looking a bit at the music and projects featuring classic rock music. I've already compared the Bee Gees' Sgt. Pepper movie to Across the Universe, for example. I do have a few more Disney videos as well coming up. So, what channels inspired you to create your own? So yes, this is just what channels you had been watching before you started. For me, it's quite a few. Saberspark, Lindsay Ellis, Just Right, Nerdstalgic. So, 2 questions. One for people who've already started their channel and others who are just starting their channel. What are you most excited for about this new channel? Or, what upcoming project are you most excited for? So yes, personally, I've worked really hard on my next video. Kind of glad I reached 100 subscribers now so that I can make this instead of releasing that straight away. I only just finished it today. Writing anything less than 3,000 words on it seemed like a blasphemy. So I'm so glad I've got that done. And then next month, I am doing a 4-part full episode ranking of a classic TV series. It's 58 episodes, it's gonna take a while. Yeah, those are the 2 big ones I'm most excited for coming up. I've got a lot more. I have an incredibly long list of things that I'm working on, or that I'm thinking of doing. But yeah, those are the things that I can definitely tell you are coming soon. What challenges do you think will be hardest to overcome? Or what has been your toughest challenge so far? Obviously one is for people who've already started their channel. The other is for people who have not yet started. So my toughest challenge so far, probably schedule. Obviously, that's only a pressure I am putting on myself. There is no one else enforcing that deadline, but I still don't regret setting myself this deadline. You know, I think that necessary pressure is good for me. I don't think it's been too harsh. I may try and change some things around a bit so it's a bit easier. Whilst I think it's been a good thing to have set that deadline, I haven't always been able to reach it. And that has been, you know, life getting in the way, which it does. What other small film criticism channels do you recommend? I don't know about you guys, but I absolutely love discovering and supporting creators who are around my size and helping each other out, giving advice. I have a group chat with some of them, and I have on my channel page a huge list of at least 30 other channels that create similar content to me. So if you want to see other creators who create similar content who are also around my size, you can go and check them out there. What apps/websites/software, etc. do you use for your channel? Okay, I have affiliate links to two of them. I'll start with the one I don't have a link for. Shotcut is the editing software I'm using at the moment. I'm thinking of moving to DaVinci because I'm struggling with using text within Shotcut. For the look of it, doing any on-screen sort of animations or moving text or anything is rather difficult. So all those amazing title cards I've been making are on Canva, which is also where I make my thumbnails. Made a few other social media posts and stuff on there. That picture of Moneypenny at the photocopier, that was also made on Canva. So yeah, it's a fantastic tool for making any kind of visual thing you need. I don't think you could really edit a full video on there, at least not with my type of content. But yeah, really fantastic. And then if you click the link in the description, I'll get like a free JPEG. Yay! And the other thing I use is vidIQ. You know, I've seen a lot of people complaining about it, but it's a toolkit. Not all of the tools will apply to you. YouTube is just too diverse for all tools to be made for your style of content and how people look for your style of content. Yes, although I have an affiliate link, I would recommend not getting the paid version. The free version just has so many different tools that you're really going to want to try it out in the free version first so you can familiarise yourself with it and take full advantage if you do get that upgrade. And secondly, you shouldn't be investing in your channel unless you absolutely have to early in the game, and you don't really need the paid version at this stage from what I can see. So I use the free version of myself, get the free version, where are you on social media, you know, so people can follow you. I am on Twitter, I am active on Reddit, but I don't really do much. I do have an Instagram. I haven't posted on there in ages, but I do have an Instagram. I will start posting it on there at some point, because I have loads of thumbnails and stuff I can post on there. How else can viewers support you? So if you have a Ko-fi or a Patreon or any kind of service or business that you are selling alongside your channel, this is where you can plug it, basically. But what I do have at the moment is a Ko-fi, so you can, or a coffee, so you can buy me a coffee on there. Or if you're really excited about the Futurama reboot, why don't you buy me 100 cups of coffee? It'll be a fun pop culture reference, and £300. So don't do that. Again, two questions: what advice would you like as a new creator, or what advice would you give to new creators if you already have some experience? Let me think. Yeah, not all advice is going to apply to you in YouTube. For example, there are some people who say, oh, YouTube videos can't be any longer than 10 minutes. 10 minutes is the absolute limit. Whereas, you know, 10 minutes is incredibly short for a video essay. I am still surprised that, you know, I've been able to make a 10-minute video essay. I'm like, isn't this too short? And yes, and then specifically for this niche, just work out how to avoid copyright stuff early. So mirroring footage, using as little audio as possible. If you do use audio, do try and avoid using music. And also, if your work is fair use, then the first stage of the appeals process isn't very scary, and apparently a lot of studios drop it automatically. So it's not something you need to worry about majorly. Do stand your ground if you can. Obviously don't put a full movie on there. So, who do you challenge next? So, is there any other creator that maybe you know that you want to encourage to do this again? I'm opening this up to anyone in my group chat. I'm going to let them all know. I'm going to send them all these questions. If you want to see these questions written down, you can just go to Ko-fi. It's absolutely free. You can see my page. You can see the questions. But, you know, if you're on there and you think, wow, this lady has written all these questions. Maybe it's, you know, £3 worth of questions. Don't do it just for the questions. Do it because you like my videos. That would be just a bit weird if you did it just for the questions. But, and finally, where should people start with your channel? So for me, it depends on what you like. If you like video essays, you can just start with video essays as a whole, or you could just start with reviews as a whole, or you could just start with something specific. For example, you could start with my classic rock playlist. If you like James Bond, you can watch my two James Bond video essays. If you like animation, you can look at my animation playlist. The one I'm probably going to recommend you start with is my Sgt. Pepper video essay. That's one I'm very proud of. But if you want something smaller, then I suggest going for my review of Pass the Ammo. It's a review of a Tim Curry film. I've reviewed two Tim Curry films so far. I think he's a fantastic actor, and I do love discussing films that are not perfect, but not terrible. Somewhere in the middle, somewhere where I can discuss the pros and cons and how it could be a little bit better. Thank you very much, guys. I can't wait to see what you guys make. See you soon.
We're not worthy! We're